Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through expert system architecture, guys. So the architecture seems to be really easy, guys. If you understand the concept, how it is working or how it is traveling, if you understand that, it's really, really easy. This expert system architecture is mostly observed in the question paper for directly for 10 marks, guys. So if you write it in an elaborated way, you can get easily, you can score 10 marks, guys, or at least 7 to 8 marks. That will be more than enough, right? Yes. So now let us go through expert system architecture. Okay, so few of you may have doubt that how can I remember this whole diagram? It's a bit confusing. So the numbers are clear, right? So I kept some numbers. So I'll be discussing in this order. So if you remember in this order and if you connect them, that will be enough, guys. Simple, right? Okay, so initially the first thing we'll be discussing is knowledge base, guys. So we can clearly say that knowledge base is the heart of the expert system. Basically, it is the place where everything is stored. Whatever you do, whatever it does, we'll be going through theoretical concepts also. Don't worry, guys. I'll be just explaining you a one-line definitions for everything. Okay. So this is an heart of the system. It consists of static and dynamic database. Static is nothing but predefined facts, and those will be available in static. Dynamic means if any new thing comes, if you are doing it now, it comes under dynamic. Okay. So the next thing is inference engine. So how you will be accessing the data in the knowledge base, guys? With the help of this inference engine only. That's the reason why here we are having inferences and control. So it is going to control the database. So there should be a direct connection and communication between these two. So that is the reason why we are having double arrows. Fine? Okay. So the third component is knowledge acquisition. So knowledge acquisition and learning module, from the name we can say. So whenever you want to inculcate or include new kind of thinking skills or any kind of things to the expert system, you will be doing it with the help of this knowledge acquisition. So it's going to learn new things according to their requirements. Okay. Okay. So this will be getting the data from the case study, guys. We'll be discussing about case study. Don't worry. Okay. So better now only let us go through case study. So case study is nothing but basically static data is fixed, right? Whereas dynamic data is new data. So this new data will be stored in the case study. And this case study will be given as a knowledge to the knowledge acquisitor so that it learns it now. So now once it learns it, it again will be represented, is stored back in the static database. So in this way from the case study, it will be going here. So from here to here and here to here. Fine. Okay. So the next we'll be discussing about user interface. From the name itself, we can say user interface. It is a medium between the expert system and the user. Simple. Okay, so that's the reason why it is having, from the user he can see and take, whereas here it will be unidirectional, or even it can be multidirectional also, it's fine. It depends on your wish, guys. Okay, so explanation module. After that, explanation module is nothing but, so okay, if you solve a problem, if I solve a problem and I don't keep any audio or anything, guys, I just solved a problem, that's it. So you may have a doubt that how can I understand without explanation? I need some explanation, right? So I need to do some explanation, only then you'll be understanding. So that is the same here. So explanation module is going to explain how it got that particular conclusion. So that part is done by the explanation module. The final one will be a special interface. Special interface we'll be discussing, guys. Don't worry. It's really simple. Okay. Okay. So now let us start with our discussion. So the first part, which I told you, is knowledge base. So knowledge base. Knowledge base is the heart of the expert system. It is responsible for storage of knowledge in the expert system. The expert system uses the knowledge to answer the queries or the given conclusion to the user. So whenever the user asks a question or asks for a particular conclusion, at that moment, this knowledge base is the main responsibility. It's responsibility to give the answer. Okay. So knowledge base is the core module of an expert system. It is of two types. Basically, we are having static database and dynamic database. Static will be consisting of rules and facts. Dynamic is nothing but particular problem which is going on presently. Fine? Okay. So after that, inference engine, the above part. It's having two parts, right? Interface, inferences and control. Okay. Inference engine. Inference engine is the module which finds an answer from the knowledge base. Right? I told you, right? So it is going to go and take the data and bring out in that way. Okay. So it is the one which decides which rules and facts will satisfy. Okay. So now let us go through knowledge acquisition. So I told you knowledge acquisition is learning. So it allows the system to acquire more knowledge regarding the problem. So from the case study we are getting here, right? So in this way we will be getting, okay, if you want, you can just shuffle them, guys, so that you can write case study a bit big and you can just explain it in the knowledge acquisition. Fine. So case study. It stores the files created by the inference engine using the dynamic database. So whatever files are created using dynamic database are stored in this case study and is used by the learning module to enrich its knowledge. So this learning module is nothing but your knowledge acquisition. Guys, better to write this first and this next. Okay. So the next part will be your user interface. User interacts with the system through the user interface only. It acts as a bridge between the user and the expert system. So it is a medium between the user and the expert system. Simple. Let us continue. Explanation module. This module helps the expert system to give the user an explanation about how the expert system concluded with that particular conclusion. So it is going to explain the user like this steps I followed and I got this result. So that way, step by step approach. Okay. And the final part is, special interface. So special interface are used for performing specialized activities in expert system. So to do any kind of special activities, these specialized inferences are used. So I hope everyone got a small idea on the architecture. Guys, please draw the diagram perfectly and just give 3 to 4 lines of explanation of each and everything, guys. So if you are having really a wide knowledge of it, you just elaborate the answer as much as you want, because it's really interesting topic. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through the differences between traditional system and the expert system. Thank you. Thanks for watching.